uniform store, 130 miles per hour.
Kids think it's funny, huh? Y'all like it? Y'all like this with no lights?
He's looking for a strobe light. Ready?
You looking for it? Yeah. Where is the strobe light? Well, we can't plug it in.
Hey Google.
Yeah. Hey Google, don't work, baby. Oh,
okay, shit. Here, hurry up.
Thank you. so. How long it's gonna take us to get this clean? Hey, yo! Valentina, who taught you the way, girl?
You're doing good.
Latest on the aftermath of Hurricane Ian. That death toll in Florida, they're climbing as residents are now trying to pick up the pieces. And Victor Oquendo, who has been covering this from the very beginning, is there in Fort Myers with more on this. Good morning, Victor.
Good morning, Cecilia. Hurricane Ian leading to an unprecedented surge in rescue response. So far, some 90,000 structures have been searched for survivors.
Hurricane Ian is now the second deadliest storm to hit the U.S. mainland this century, behind Hurricane Katrina. The Associated Press reported at least 101 people have now died, including 92 in Florida. In the hardest hit areas, all that remains are piles of debris from destroyed homes and businesses. some residents are still struggling to come to terms with their new reality.
I mean, I've been through storms since I was a kid, born and raised in Florida, Donna's, you know, the big ones and everything. And I've seen devastation, but I've never seen it this widespread. Even with Charlie, it's probably a 20-mile wide swath. This is enormous.
About 99,000 customers in southwestern Florida are still without power more than a week after Hurricane Ian made landfall in the state. The Uvalde.